Butte, Montana. Home to Copper Kings William Andrews Clark, Marcus Daly, and F. Augustus Heinze. The town began as a mining camp in a Rocky Mountain summit valley near the Continental Divide when gold and silver were discovered in the hills. And though gold and silver were found in the area, it is not what brought the city its wealth. What really brought people to Butte was the advent of electricity and its conductor of choice, copper. The copper mines drew people from around the world, and the area quickly became a boomtown. At one point, it was one of the largest cities in the Rocky Mountain West. In the 1950s, however, that all changed. The price of copper began to go down, and competition grew more and more fierce. By the early 1980s, all mining operations had ceased. In 1986, they were reopened, and in fits and starts, it still continues to this day, all dependent on the price of minerals and the cost of operating the mines. Just as quickly as they came, people left, leaving behind a toxic, scarred landscape. But amidst all that, there are still a few gems to be found. The uptown area of Butte has recently received recognition by the government as a National Historic Landmark District, one of the largest in the nation. More and more, efforts are being made to preserve what cultural heirlooms we have left. The goal is to draw more people to the city to see a glimpse of what life was like in the mining boomtown. One of the most iconic buildings in the area, the Copper King Mansion, once home to the mining tycoon William Andrews Clark, now belongs to a pair of siblings, Aaron Siegel and John Thompson. For three generations, their family has owned this home and has done their best to maintain its integrity.
My grandmother, Mrs. Cody, bought the house in 1953, and she bought it as a real estate investment. She fixed it all up, and while she lived here, she rented the rooms for apartments. And then after her death, my mother took over the house, our mother, and she actually started the different businesses. She did all the research on Clark and opened the house for tours in about 1968. She started doing weddings and dinner parties and eventually had made the house into a restaurant. And then in her late years, in about 1989, she started the bed and breakfast business. So today we do bed and breakfast and tours, and we do occasional parties and weddings and dinner parties and things like that.
As a privately owned and operated business, they had done well to sustain their enterprise. However, time in the harsh Montana winters had not been kind to the mansion. They realized that if they wanted to protect what was on the interior, they needed help protecting what was on the exterior. That is when they came across the Historic Preservation Grant Program.
We had help from grant writers and historic preservation people, and so we spent a year ago, the winter, meeting, and I did a lot of the research here of information that was accumulated by my mother, and so we would meet, and then the preservation people and the grant writers, they took this information and they helped us write the grant. And so I would say it took us 6 months to do the writing for the grant, and it was very fortunate that they helped us, because I think it was their skills and expertise that acquired the grant for the Copper King Mansion.
The main purpose of the National Historic designation is to not so much rebuild what was here or the likes of that. It is to preserve what we do have and improve what we do have.
Well, we had a new boiler put in. We restored the rain gutters, and we rebuilt the front porch.
And after that, we painted it all. And we've just completed that before the snow started to fly. And from our perspective, the mansion is, the exterior of the mansion is absolutely gorgeous. We were very fortunate to have the crew, that some of the local contractors that took a personal interest in doing the job Not just good enough. They did it better than good enough. And we are very pleased with what they did.